I am an aficionado of YouTube, and I admit it. I often tell people I don't have a television, and I haven't had one for 17 years, probably closer to 15 years. But what I don't tell them is that my TV is when I go to bed at night, and I watch YouTube videos for probably about an hour or so. It helps relax me, take me out of my usual teacher mode, or if I've been quilting, it takes my mind away from other things and just allows me to focus on issues that really aren't important because I don't watch serious things on YouTube. I do listen to audiobooks though. In the evening when I quilt, I listened to audiobooks, and my mind was a bit relieved some time ago when I read an article saying that listening to an audiobook or someone reading to you is as of much benefit as actually reading the text. And as an English teacher, that's important to me. And I've read enough books in my life. I've read hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. I don't know if I've read thousands, but I have read hundreds of books in my time, so I know how to read. So I quilt and I listen to audiobooks, and I usually don't listen to serious audiobooks while I quilt. I like Agatha Christie and Niall Marsh, and I will listen to science fiction and some horror stories. And so that also is a diversion from teaching English and being serious and teaching Beowulf and Gawain and the Green Knight and discussing the Victorian and the medieval era, which are the two courses that I'm teaching right now in graduate courses. I also teach composition, and I teach at literature at the local community college, but that literature at the community college is not nearly as in-depth as are my graduate courses. So, oh yeah, totally digressed there. Totally forgot what it was that I was saying, but I'm back on track now. So I like to watch YouTube videos, and I will scroll through just aimlessly. And I sometimes I don't can't say how often I see them. I see videos that tell old women they shouldn't wear their hair long. Now, I've often related the story that when I turned 40, my hair was not even as long then as it is now. But my older sister told me that I needed to cut my hair. And I said, "Why do I need to cut my hair?" And she said, "Because old women just don't look good with long hair." Well, I was 40. I wasn't old. Now I'm 71. I'm old. And you can see I took my sister's advice. But what I find ironic about that is that my sister would have been 46 at the time, and she always wore her hair very short. But later, when she got into her 60s, she died, it'll be 2 years in June. When she got into her 60s and into her 70s, she let her hair get longer and down to here. And I said to her one day, "Kitty, you told me that I needed to cut my hair because old women don't look good with long hair." And she said, "I did not." And I said, "Oh, yes, you did. I will never forget that." Because my older sister, you know, was always telling me what it is that I should or shouldn't do. It just wasn't with my hair, but how I dressed and other things. So, this issue of old women and long hair, I've actually researched long hair and hair in general and women. And the thing is about the long hair, and I might have said this in another video, but you know, saying something once has never kept me from reiterating it later. Long hair and long hair in particular is associated with fertility. A woman who had long hair was considered to be fertile. And so that was the reason why old women, well, in the old days, old women didn't cut their hair. They just wore it up and out of sight. And now they are for generations, when women were allowed to cut their hair, they would cut their hair short because long hair on an old woman is false advertisement. At 71, I am not fertile, and I haven't been for a very long time. But I still wear my hair long because I like it. But back to the issues of these videos telling old women they shouldn't wear long hair. I have spent much of my life rebelling against what I have been told that I should do, especially when it opposed what I wanted to do or knew what was best for me. And now that I am old, this is even more pronounced. I live alone. I've also been told that maybe I should get married again. That's not going to happen. And there are other things that, not so much dropped hints lately because I've become a recluse. And so I don't really associate with people who get to know me because most people, frankly, just bore me. I have no interest in them. I do talk to people in strangers in stores, you know, Walmart or Aldi or any store. I just talk to strangers. And it's really interesting how many strangers comment on my hair. And it's always complimentary. No one has ever said, you know, maybe you should cut your hair. You'd look younger. Well, I'm 71. I don't care how I try, strive to look younger. I don't wear makeup. And I just want to be myself. I know that's trite, but it is true. So when I see these videos and they're telling that old women that they shouldn't wear their hair long, that is BS. Women should wear their hair how they like. All people should wear their hair how they like. And if old women want to dye their hair pink and purple, that's not my thing, but it's not my place to tell them that they should not do that, or young people who do that. That's not my place. I see some hairstyles that I think are unflattering, and I also see long hair on all women of all ages, and men too, that is not, in my opinion, attractive because it's very thin, it's very scraggly, it needs to be, trimmed. So that's their business. If they want to wear their hair like that, let them. But that too, now how many times have I said that? I said that reiterating is not an issue with me. Back to the issue of old women in long hair and needing to cut it. Now my hair, when it is not in a braid, is down just to the bottom of my derriere. I do trim it on a regular basis. In fact, I trimmed just not even an inch off of the ends the other day. And I do this because the ends do get scraggly and doesn't look good. And it's also unhealthy because those split ends, they just keep splitting. And then it affects the hair higher up from the ends. And so these people tell me I need to cut my hair because I'm old. They don't say it's because you are giving false advertisement by wearing your hair long. But like my sister, long hair just doesn't look good, old women. Well, you know something? Oh, and the main selling point, old hair makes old women. Excuse me, not old hair, because my hair is old. Long hair on old women makes them look old. So if you want to look younger, cut your hair. Well, I resent that so much emphasis is put on looking younger. I'm 71 years old. And that's a reiteration too. I'm okay with looking my age. And it's also interesting and ironic that people often tell me I don't look 71. And in large part is because I have long hair and old women don't typically wear their hair long. So where old women should wear their hair, young women should wear their hair, and men of all ages should wear their hair the way they want to wear it. I had something else there that flitted through my mind when I was going through that, and I have forgotten what it said because, you know, I'm old and getting senile, and I can't always remember what it is that that I say. Oh, I remember. The thing is about hair. People ask me what my secret is. Do I use a certain shampoo? Do I do this or I do that? Nope. It's in the genes. I'm told my great grandmother had very long and lush hair. She died at an early age, so I don't know what it would look like when she was older. My grandmother's hair was very thin. My mother's hair was thin. My sister's hair was average. I have a couple of cousins who have very thick hair. And my hair, when I was younger, was much thicker than it is now. It was also a different texture. It was quite coarse and it's finer now. It's not ultra fine, but it is finer, not nearly as coarse. And so that is, I don't do anything for my hair. I wash it and I don't wash it a lot. I don't wash my hair that often because it strips out the oils. And I will blow my bangs dry, and after I wash it, I'll dry it. I wash my bangs just about every day, though, because that's where it gets oily. So I lucked out in the jean department. This is 10 minutes and 50 seconds long, and I could just babble on here forever. But the point of why I'm making this video is wear your hair the way you want to wear your hair. I don't care what other people's opinion is on me, on my looks, how I dress. The opinions that matter to me are, if I'm being cruel or unkind. And, and of course, I care what my schools think about me, but my hair doesn't make a difference to my schools, especially being online. And it wouldn't matter even if I weren't all online. Stop there. And stop babbling and wear your hair long. And if you're guys, I will tell you one thing that does annoy me about older men and hair. And this is from my perspective. And if you're doing this with your hair, that's your business. I hate seeing those little skinny pigtails. The little braid that's about a quarter of an inch wide. So yeah, I have my own biases, but I don't go up to men and say, "You need to cut off that pigtail because it looks crappy." And I also don't see any videos on YouTube telling old men, "Guys, if you have that little skinny pigtail, cut it off." Nah, it's only old women who get the brunt. That's all.